Hello and welcome to today's development update of December 2020. Since my last news update, I have created new videos about scalar waves. The subject is rooted in my experience since 40 years when I saw the video from Borderland Science and the presentation from Eric Dollard. It was about Tesla's longitudinal electricity. He used a pair of pancake coils and connected them via ground. He went then on to the beach and received the signal from the lab a couple of thousands feet away. I replicated these coils in 2010 and posted my first test with them on YouTube. Here's a picture of them. The base for those tests was Tesla's patent for wireless energy transmission. Dr. Constantin Mile wrote a book about the documentation for scalar wave technologies in the year 2000. Which is a tutorial for his experimental kit that he sells on his website. A book I highly recommend to read. Here is the cover of the picture of the book. I have today prepared for you a short experiment I currently produce for my members. In this video, I will demonstrate the Hertzian wave versus the scalar wave and with a special modified signal as a surprise for you. Let me give you an overview of the experimental setup on my lab table. Here on the table you see two Tesla coils known to you with primary and secondary. Left is the transmitter connected to a signal generator and right the receiver. As antenna I use the well-known spheres on both sides. In the middle of the table I have for the transmitter two DMMs where I measure the voltage and current from the source via the load and LED. The desktop MDMM on the right is to measure the same on the receiver side. In the center is a spectrum analyzer where I measure the magnetic field strength which is radiated from the coils. I will demonstrate now. So I have prepared now my table for the experiment. Please observe also the oscilloscope in the top left corner. The yellow line is here for the transmitting side. And on the other side is the receiver in green. So you can read the voltage, you will see also the waveform. So we have here again the DMMs who measures the power input, and we have as indicator also the LED. This LED requires at least 5 microampere of current to illuminate slightly and close to or around 2 volt. So we have then this DMM on the other side where we have the measurement with the LED again on the receiving side. We measure currently the ground, or let's say the base EMF radiation from the house and from the all the appliances which are currently activated here in this room and on this table, and we measure 14.47 milliampere per meter. I will activate now the signal generator, which I set currently to 4 volt. That means it's much higher because these LEDs, they are 3 volt LEDs, maximum and maximum current draw of 20 milliampere. So if I go close to this value, I will burn them out, and they are via a bridge rectifier on both sides connected. So I will start now. So here at 361 kilohertz, as you can see, I have set this DMM to microampere, very important. You see at the moment 4000 microampere, which is 4 milliampere, and we have on the receiving side 1 milliampere. Let me go up in the frequency. And when we go close to resonance in the Hertzian wave range, we go technically to the broadcast level where our spheres here are radiating energy, and you can see that also here on the spectrum analyzer. Let me go in closer. So I adjusted on the oscilloscope, as you can see here, that I have on both sides the same value. It looks like that.
Yes. So this is 420 kilohertz. This is a Hertzian wave. And as you can see, we have a lot of radiation going on here. And in a Hertzian wave, we are transmitting everything transverse via our antenna, which is in this example is our ball. And in Hertzian wave as well, we have a very sensitive system because of air core coils. We can change everything here. You can see if I put my hand a little bit in here, I can change, detune everything and change the values. And you can read here also on the DMM, the changes in current. But what you also see is on the receiving side, there is almost nothing. So nothing going on here. And let me show you this one as well. If I put it here on the receiver side, just here as an example, on the antenna, that's also a very interesting phenomenon. Let's see if it goes through. We have 2.3 ampere per meter currently. Let's go a little bit further. It goes high up. It takes almost 2 cycles to calculate that correctly. So 246 milliampere. Yeah, okay. Now let's go to the receiving side. So we have here, let's go wait for a second until that is finished and I bring it back to the center. So 742, so we have much more radiation on the receiving side. That's an interesting phenomenon, but that also means that we have more energy in the field. It is not available to us for real transmission. It is in the field and it's lost. That's the transverse, that's the Hertzian wave, that's how it currently works, that's how our world is currently set up. Well, let me bring that back in the center. Now I will tune for the scalar wave. So scalar wave is between 1.4 and 1.6, 1.7 times higher than the Hertzian wave. The scalar wave is also nature's wave. If you take any organism which can multitask and multidimensional, take your human body, we have nerve cells which are very, very slow. 2 meters per second is an electric propagation in a nerve cell. However, our body works much better than a PC which can process everything only in a serial way. Now let's go up in the frequency. We have still no power on the receiving side. We have 4 milliampere on the transmitting side here. We go higher, 4.1, 4.2 milliampere, 4.3 milliampere on the transmitting side. And now we go down and we have light on the other side. Please observe this DMM. It is increasing, whereas the transmitting side is decreasing. And here we have an increase now. We go close to the value and also observe the oscilloscope. Green is the receiver, yellow is the transmitter. You will see now that we have more energy available on the receiving side and less energy available on the transmitting side. More, more, more. I'm at 600 microampere currently. I will zoom in closer in a second. Let me see if I can get that better. So we had 500, I had here 450 microampere. Let me talk that in from oscilloscope. So we measure now on the transmitting side 13.5 volt, and I measure on the receiving side 54 volts. So that's a factor of 3 currently. See if I can improve on that. Like that, 14.5 volt and 55 volt. So one of the aspects of the scalar network is that you cannot disturb the signal anymore. That means if I go with my hand here and I try to disturb, yes, you can see I can disturb a little bit the signal, but there's nothing changing. And also we have here on the spectrum analyzer a very low radiation point, which comes only a bit from the coil. Now, I have 430 or 400 microampere here, 2.5 volt here. I have 1.99 volt over there and 4.76 milliampere. That's a clear, very, very high value of a COP over 1. Now, the magic happens if you change the signal. The signal here in this example has to be an arbitrary signal, which cannot be a signal we are using for power transmission. Our world is built on MOSFETs. Our world is built on half bridge, full bridge, class E amplifier, and they all require a square wave. A square wave is drawing power, and a square wave is not the way nature works. It works with a specific sound, and they are not based on square wave. So I have this sound here, and I want to demonstrate that to you. And I will zoom in now to go closer so that you can see that. Let me do that. Okay. Now let me change my signal. Okay, we are at 0.1. Let's see if I can get that. 0.1 microampere. 0.1 microampere. 1.69 volt or 1.69 volt over here. I have 1.84 volt over here and 3.35 milliampere. Light is out on this LED. Light is full bright on over the other ID. And what you can see now here on the oscilloscope is that we have a factor now of 5. What I can do now is I can put my hand, let me zoom back out so that you can see what I'm doing. Technically, at this level, these spheres have no function anymore. Or let's say they appear not to have any function anymore. If I go here and I touch here, yes, I destroy that. But what happens on the output side? Nothing. I have still full power. It doesn't change at all. I can take that away. It doesn't matter. I have my power. I have power here. The only thing I need, and that rumor has it, that you require for an alternative energy system only voltage but not current. But technically that's not possible. We need to have always a little bit of current. But a little bit of current is for me 0.1 microampere and a little bit of voltage. But how can that be that I have then on the other side 1.83 watt and 3.34 milliampere? And that's for 4 volt. If I increase now the volt, let's go to 5 volt. Let's go to 6 volt on a. So I have now 6 volt on a signal generator. Let's go on that. And I'm at 1.5. I can still tune that. Let's go back. If I can change that. So 1.2, 1.3 microampere, 2.374 volt. And now I have 5.46 milliampere over there and over 2 volt. I'm touching again. It changes slightly on the output side, yes. I have a little bit more current draw here, as it shows here. But technically, I can shunt that down to ground. Yeah, and I have still output on the other side. So I said only a very small change. So, I will give you now a little summary and we conclude this test.
The discussion in Professor Miles' book from universities and companies around the world did point into this direction. However, nobody in the world, as far as I know, did think about the signal type in aspect of scalar waves. It was, however, thought and mentioned in the free energy world to use frequency modulation with mixed signals. But this is the first step. The challenge remains. We need to build an amplifier which is 100% efficient but can transmit signals undisturbed. And I want to make clear that pulse waves are not working either. I have already tested it. If you want to learn about how it's done and performance elevation of various coil systems, because this is not a pancake coil, then please join me as member on my website and support me. On YouTube, please subscribe, hit the like button and the notification bell. Thank you, and I hope I see you soon as members on my website.